Super Mario 3D World is probably already a given for the Switch. I think most of us can already expect it to come, and it's just up to Nintendo when to reveal this thing. It's been leaked and rumored heavily for a while now, and now we sit with even more speculation on possible 3D Mario games, with this one still at the top of the list. So of course, just like all the other leaks and rumors, I covered every single one of them, including Galaxy 64 and Sunshine, talking about what they need to add for the Nintendo Switch. Now today, we look at Super Mario 3D World and see the changes that we need with this game. So if you enjoyed today's video, make sure you leave a like and subscribe if you guys are new, and please make sure you hit that notification bell to stay up to date on all things Nintendo all the time. Without further ado, let's get into our list of what Super Mario 3D World needs to add for the Nintendo Switch. First off, let's talk about the overall graphics and the music of Super Mario 3D World. This game is still not that old. It debuted on the Nintendo Wii U, which still was capable of pumping out HD visuals, so really nothing is going to have to change with the graphics. Maybe a slight enhancing, I don't know, maybe some color changes, but overall it's going to pretty much stay the same, and same with the music. The music is phenomenal, and it has a great orchestral sound, and I think everything will stay the same with those two categories. There's really no need to change it. This is going to be almost straight up a port at this point, rather than a remake, so just pretty much keep those things the way they are. Super Mario 3D World has so much replay value, it's ridiculous. Each and every stage has something that you can go back to and try to 100%. Every stage has 3 green stars, a hidden stamp collectible, and you must finish that stage with every single character in the game. Well, this is pretty easy if you play with multiple people at once, but still, it's a pretty big feat, nevertheless. Also, you must get the top of the flagpole of every stage at least once to get that golden flag. And man, this will keep you playing for a very long time, let me tell you. It definitely did for me. So as far as collectibles and extras in each level goes, you really don't have to add much because they've already kind of hit it out of the park with extra content for each level. To continue on that replay value train, 3D World also has multiple bonus worlds that you can visit after collecting lots of these things throughout the game, and these levels also amp up the difficulty for even the toughest of players. So yes, you clicked on this video to find out what the heck is Super Mario 3D World going to add. Landon, you haven't gave us anything yet. Well, hold your horses, I'm getting there. This game is just already full of so much stuff, Nintendo really doesn't have to do much to enhance it, but there are some things to make it a lot better than what it is and make people maybe want to double dip again. Here's what we got. So first off, let's look at the characters, because there is a pretty hefty amount of characters in this game to start off with. Right now we have Mario, which is an all-around player, Luigi jumps high, Peach floats, and Toad runs fast. Yes, this is Mario Bros. 2 all over again. But then we got Rosalina, which actually included her Galaxy Spin, well, technically Mario's, but now she has it. So I decided to add a couple more characters, because why not? First off, we got Yoshi, which is not in the game at all right now, which would work pretty well. He can have his flutter jump and his tongue to eat enemies. Wario can join, and he would have his shoulder bash, while Luigi could even get in there with his racket smack, golf club, or baseball bat, representing some type of Mario sports title. I don't know, it's up to Nintendo to choose. Then you could also have Donkey Kong, which could have a barrel roll, a ground pound, or a powerful punch. Now this is where we start to get a little crazy, I'll admit it. It's crazy, but just hear me out. What if we get a guest star character, and that guest star character can be Link? What if we get Link from The Legend of Zelda as a playable character? Now, it's not completely out of the realm of possibility. We see lots of Nintendo crossovers from Mario Maker, and even when they put Hyrule Castle into Sonic Lost World, we've seen this before, they can definitely do it. Link would have the same exact moves and pretty much flow as every other character in the game. He can jump, and he can roll, and he can do everything that every other character can do, but the only add-on plus that he would have for this character is he has his sword and his shield, and maybe all he can do is just slice his sword in front of him to chop enemies. Nintendo is definitely no stranger to adding weird things in video games. I mean, just look at Piranha Plant and Smash. And I don't think this will tarnish any of these series because they've both been well established for a while now. Everybody knows what The Legend of Zelda is, and everybody has played a Mario game. So why not have the two come together in this cool 3D Mario experience? Because it's not really necessarily a big 3D Mario game. It's a complete, almost friendly arcade game that you play with your friends. So why not throw Link in? It'd be so much fun. Come on, Nintendo, just think about it. Just think about it. But having even more characters than the original will greatly increase the replay value, making it a ton of fun to go back and play through the levels once again with these new characters. Next, with all these characters, let's increase the multiplayer cap, because currently you can only play Super Mario 3D World with 4 characters. Let's increase it, because it seems as if this is possible with the inclusion of the double cherry item, which duplicates the player into multiple different copies. And as of right now, if you have 4 players on a screen and everybody gets a double cherry, you can have a total of 8 characters. characters. And I'm sure there's even more with the inclusions of extra double cherries in certain levels. So I'm sure the game can handle running multiple different characters. I just think it'd be a lot of fun to have like an 8-person, everybody running around a stage, complete hectic craziness. It's stupid and it wouldn't be fun for some players because they were just trying to be completing the level, but it's just that right type of crazy that will keep people so entertained, just like Super Smash Bros. 8-player battles. Super Mario 3D World could also have a throwback level to a past game, similar to how Super Mario Galaxy 2 did a throwback galaxy to Super Mario 64's Womp's Fortress, so this could be something that'd be very interesting. It's a different take because this isn't a 3D sandbox open world Mario game, it's more of a fixed camera 3D Mario game that we started to experience, a more linear one. So it might be kind of hard to have a past 3D Mario level here, but I'm sure they could work it out in some sort of way and maybe remake it to fit in Super Mario 3D World correctly. So I thought of some fun ways to play online with friends, and they could have 3 different game modes. The first would be racing. You can race against others online to see who completes the level the quickest. You could either have the levels adjusted for multiple racers, or give everyone their own level to race on and race against ghost versions of their competitors, so that way they're not interfering with each other along the way and messing up parts of the track. The second mode can be strictly just multiplayer, but online, similar to how you play locally, you can win a crown by getting the most points and it'll all be point-based and just basically completing levels, but this time you can play along with people online. And maybe the third online mode forces players to beat the game all over again, but with online players only. So you have to have a team and you have to play online, similar to Federation Force. Never mind, forget I even said that. Or they could give you a pack of pre-made levels and you and your team will have to work together in order to complete them. This would be more of a co-op challenge and something akin to Luigi's Mansion Scarescraper. These levels could be a whole bunch of the little ones like the Mystery House Marathon, and maybe they add like hundreds of these type of levels for you to complete with people online. That would be a lot of fun. Another thing they could add is maybe some more bosses and tweak and enhance some of the ones that are currently in the game. Lots of them are incredibly easy and don't really require much at all to defeat, and I think if they added some more or maybe enhance some of them or at least give them a harder mode, I think it would be really good for the game. And speaking of harder mode, maybe just add that, a harder mode. Maybe there's a difficulty setting that you can adjust in the very beginning of the game to determine how difficult you want this game to be, if you want it to be extremely nail-biting or super easy picking up flowers and walking through the park pretty much every Mario game ever. This is really all the additions I could think of. I really think we should get more characters and at least more online modes. Those are the most exciting. More characters will make you want to go back and replay all types of levels because there are some really good levels, and with everybody having a different special ability, this will make it even more fun to go back as. Was the Link thing a little out of the world? I think it was, but you know what? It could be so much fun. I think it'd be just a blast to walk around a Mario game as Link. Come on, I know you do too. I know you do. And also those online modes would be a lot of fun to play with people, maybe even complete the game all over again with online friends or just online strangers. I would also love to do those mini levels because I think it'd be a lot of fun just to jump into a pack of mini levels and complete them with people and get points and maybe even rewards for it. Maybe even some costumes for your characters for doing so, like Super Mario Odyssey has. So there could always be some type of fun way to continue playing this game if these things are added. And those were all the 3D Mario games that I could cover. So if you guys missed any of the past ones, including 64, Sunshine, and even the Galaxies, feel free to check out my other videos and my chats about them on the channel. It's a lot of information, so try not to overwhelm yourself. I've been getting really excited about this leak and rumor, and I just cannot wait to get my hands on a 3D Mario collection. Obviously, we still have some leaks and rumors to talk about, including the Paper Mario game, and I have so much to go over with that one, but there's a lot of stuff to go over before these things are actually revealed and released. But, like always, let me know what you guys think of these leaks. First off, what 3D Mario are you most excited about? Personally, I cannot wait for Super Mario Sunshine. It's my favorite game, and to see this game remade and remastered after many years, ever since playing it as a kid, it's just gonna be awe-inspiring to me. I just cannot wait to see what that looks like, and that's what I'm most excited about. But what are you most excited about for Super Mario 3D World in particular? And what things may I have missed that you think should be included in the HD remake of this game? Please feel free to let me know in the comments down below. And if you have any other questions, please feel free to ask me on the Discord. The link is in the description below. But thank you guys so much for tuning in today, and I will see you in the next one. See you guys.